It's received a lot of media attention, but I don't think it's received enough media attention. We have less than 3 weeks of irrigation water left. That's it. I think it's high noon for the city council and the mayor to start implementing a one-day watering phase. This has been overdue for, I think, at least a month. We've got less than 3 weeks of water left. After that, our fire hydrants are going to have low pressure. If there's ever a house fire or a brush fire, which there's a brush fire every day right now happening in Lee County or Collier County, you know, the mayor is going to have to do some explaining. If there's ever a fire and the firefighters show up and the water pressure is too low for them to put out that fire.
I've sat down with a gentleman that's an expert in that area, and he gave me a great education on the water levels and what we can do better as a city. It came up last night at council as well. We're currently purchasing water from our neighbors, but there's other things that we can do within the city to ensure that, you know, the future residents have the water, the same abilities and the same things that we have here.
There's a large part of Cape Coral that's still on the well system, so they can't produce the reuse water that they need to support the system. And I feel that by getting more people online, you may need to build more plants to do that, because it's a large city, so you're going to need, you know, that operation to do that. And it's going to cost a lot of money. We're going to have to do that, though. And I think that when you get more system use producing the reuse water, then you won't have the same issues that you have right now.
What are we going to do about future storage of water to use during the dry season? As we've seen over the past couple of 3 weeks, that's become a real issue. But what we're starting to bring forward are some of the solutions we've been working on, not out of the works, but, you know, and not out of the eye, but probably not pushed forward because they weren't quite completed. Mm-hmm. You know, the agreement with FGUA to take their, you know, end product water and bring it over to mix with our and use in our irrigation system. Mm-hmm. The potential purchase of a old quarry mine that's sitting there with like 2 billion gallons of water that we could easily, not easily, but could easily at some point in the time, right, bring down and replenish our canals during the drier seasons.
But I will say to you, for recalling the conversations that we had prior to me leaving and just hearing now, there's nothing you can do when it's not raining, all right? So let's identify that, number one. So our canal system then draws on the water cycle that's supplied from the rain itself. So when it's not raining, then certainly we're going to have to take a look at how we're doing business until such time that we can replenish the supply. Now, prior to that, but what does that mean? That might mean, as I've heard and reading, that we might need to have a conversation as a community and say, look, we might need to take some steps, i.e., do we want to consider maybe watering on an alternate schedule, a hybrid schedule, just to get us through this point in time? Because anyone who's been here like myself knows that this happens periodically, and we will always work through it. I will say, though, prior to me leaving, that we were talking about the idea of having a water that could be stored or piped in order to help with these type of situations. So what I'm saying to you is not a simple fix, but that is something that we can work on, and maybe we can help ourselves get through this acute point in time.